Welcome back, class. Today's class, we'll be looking at why an entrepreneur would need to conduct a feasibility analysis to ensure the success of his business. This is Barry. He believes he can invent a super cool jetpack. He swears that you can fly over short distances with it strapped on your back. Barry, are you getting a little carried away with this idea? What you mean you want to mass produce these jetpacks and export it all over the world? Hold up, Barry, hold up. I mean, bruh, this is a great idea. But how do you know this idea will work? Does it even make sense? Who will buy this product, Barry? Barry, did you do a feasibility analysis on this product?
A feasibility analysis? What's that?
Well, I am so happy that you want to know what a feasibility analysis is. Simply put, it basically determines whether the venture idea makes sense and can be realized effectively. The feasibility analysis is a systematic analysis of the various aspects of a proposed entrepreneurial venture. Its main purpose is to flesh out issues with a business idea, especially those issues which may hamper or prevent its success. It can also help anticipate problems which may result in losses or failure of the business. Now let's try to understand the purpose of a feasibility analysis a little more. Well, firstly, when you analyze all the various aspects of your proposed business venture and you conclude that it is in fact workable, sensible, and feasible, you can use this to attract investors and access funding, especially if you can offer a favorable return on their investments and minimize their risk. Secondly, a feasibility analysis can be a great starting point to formulate your business plan, which is like a roadmap for all the firm's activities. Not only can a feasibility analysis help you to assess the proposed business venture's ability to generate a profit from its commercial activities, it can also help you to determine whether there is even a target market for your goods and services. Additionally, if the proposed venture is not entirely feasible, the feasibility analysis can help with developing a contingency plan, in other words, a plan B. There are so many benefits to conducting a feasibility study. We could just touch on a few right now. Well, firstly, it takes a measure twice and cut once approach. That is the old tailor's wise advice. Clearly, it fosters prudence by allowing the business owner or the potential business owner to understand the costs and benefits involved so that these costs are not underestimated, nor are the revenues overstated. Trust me, this saves time, energy, and other precious resources in the long run, as it identifies the barriers and potential losses before major investments are made. It helps the business owner to decide, most importantly, whether to proceed or not.
So, miss, you think I should do a feasibility study?
But of course, Barry, you should. You must weigh the pros and cons of this business idea to see if it makes sense and to identify the main issues before you even start. You don't want to start something and then you run out of money or you make a loss or you fail terribly. For all we know, the research and development cost may be way too high for you to generate a profit. We don't even know if there are going to be enough people who want to buy this product. Furthermore, we don't even know how safe this product is. Come to think about it, Barry, I think you should calm down before you hurt yourself. I am now...